everyone. Welcome to the English Devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence asking forgiveness of my sins so my prayer can reach your holy throne. Thank you, Lord God, for this day that you have given us. Thank you for your compassion and your mercy. Thank you for our life and our health. Father, you are so great and you are so kind to us. I thank you and I praise you because we are in your hands. Your love for us never fails. There is nothing or no one that can pluck us out of your hands of love. Father, I thank you for that. I ask that you will forgive me of any sins and offenses that I've done against you so that my prayer may enter your throne. Lord, as we come before this devotional, I ask that you will open up our spiritual eyes and our minds and our hearts and our ears to receive your word, to make changes that we need to make, to do your will, to listen to your voice. Lord God, you are the good Father. You are the righteous King. You are the just Judge. And we thank you and we praise you. Father, if there is somebody who is struggling with their faith, maybe they're feeling numb. Maybe they're not feeling much of anything. Maybe they're doubting whether they belong in your family or not, whether they are anointed or not, or a member or not. Lord, I ask that you will meet them where they are. Show yourself to them. Reveal yourself to them, Lord. Place a hedge of protection, Lord, around them so that the evil one cannot penetrate. The evil one cannot have victory. Father God, these things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled A New Sunrise. It was written by Mirari Martinez and translated by Nelson Berries. Our biblical base comes from Isaiah chapter 58, verses 7 through 10. So says the word of God. Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter when you see the naked, to clothe them and not to turn away from your own flesh and blood? Then your light will break forth like the dawn and your healing will quickly appear. Then your righteousness will go before you and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. Then you will call and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and he will say, Here I am. If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with the pointing finger and malicious talk, and if you spend yourselves in behalf of the hungry and satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then your light will rise in the darkness, and your night will become like the noonday. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. The darkness of the night is gloomy and sad. The night takes away our hope. How many times are we unable to fall asleep, or we look forward to the arrival of the new morning? And when we see that the darkness recedes and the light of the new day dawns, joy and hope return to us. We hear the chirping of the birds. The morning air surrounds us to bring health to our bodies. The whole movement of life that with each night gives us a new morning. When I read the Word of God, I find that Jesus is the bright morning star that lights up our lives and has shone in our hearts, has dissipated the darkness, has removed the night and light our ways. When Jesus died on the cross, the veil of the temple was torn in two. The earth shook and the rocks split and the tombs were opened. But on the third day, he rose again in a dawn that is for you and for me. The representation of our resurrection in Jesus Christ when he comes in the clouds of glory to take us to that homeland where there will be no more night, but there will always be a new eternal dawn of glory. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we sometimes go through the darkness. Maybe it's a situation, maybe it's a circumstance. Maybe because it's our own sin that has caused it, or the sin of somebody else that has caused this darkness. But we must go on. We must press forward. We must persevere, because joy comes in the morning. After the darkness, there is a sunrise that is new. The sun will shine again. We will see glory. Jesus will have the victory in our circumstance, in our situations. So my brothers and sisters, don't give up, because when Jesus died on the cross, he rose again 3 days later, and we can claim victory. Victory in the name of Jesus. Victory over our sin struggle. Victory over our situation, over our circumstance, and over sin, period. My brothers and sisters, don't give up. A new sunrise, a new morning is coming for you. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
For moments I have spent recalling all the pain and failures of my past. I repent for dwelling on the things beyond my power to change. Those chains that held me fast. I will go on, my past I leave behind me. I gladly take his mercy and his love. He is joy. Strength and sweet release. I know he is, and I am his. I will go on. Give up the bitterness and hate, the blaming man in fate for all my discontent. The guilt and pain I empty from my cup, so God can fill it up with peace and sweet content. I will go on, my past I leave behind me. I gladly take his mercy and his love. Strength and sweet release.
What a beautiful song, my brothers and sisters. I will go on, no matter what life throws my way, no matter what circumstance I may face, I will go on. And now, my brothers and sisters, we invite you to check out our YouTube channel, SCC English Ministry, for the daily Bible reading as we journey through the book of Ezekiel. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.